they dominate after getting roughed up a bit in the first inning of the start. So I'll give a lot of credit for what he's been able to do.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Yeah, Shockey let that first pitch go right there. High fastball, but usually those ones travel the furthest.
Squared that one up just a little late.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. You cannot be late right there. That was right in the wheelhouse.
And he swings here and sends one in the air, deep down the right field line. Nearly a big fly to start the inning instead of foul ball. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
Pretty standard fastball right there, 0-2. Now he's changed the eye level of the batter so he can start working something in like an off-speed curveball down in the zone.
Looking for the strikeout, here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Reese retired, and there's one away.
Well, you know you made a real nice pitch when you bounce it in the dirt, and you still get the hitter to swing at it. That tells me that there's a lot of deception in that pitch right now.
Digging in the switch hitter, Harold Reese. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Good breaking ball that time, in for a strike. The 0-1 pitch. Softly hit here to the left side. And this will be no problem over the third, and there's the first out. Striding in once again, Horace Simone. For a base hit here as he gets this one down. Reese is up with it, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Ronald Torre is the next to bat. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Set to deliver on 3-0. And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss.
Great off-speed pitch right there. He was definitely sitting fastball, wanted to turn and burn. Everything went flying. This pitcher might be on the attack with that pitch all game. Yeah, well, when a guy's swinging the bat as well as he's been, this is a smart move. No reason to tempt fate out there.
Digging in and looking for more, Christopher Hood. He'll be looking for something he can drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Lifted out towards straightaway center field. Moving under it, Ratliff makes the play, one away. Digging in once again, Joaquin Ramirez. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Ramirez.
Soft liner toward first, but this is speared by the first baseman. So a crucial moment here, and standing in, Zachary Lamb, and he does so representing the possible go-ahead run. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Throw in time, and the ball game is over.
Hey, it took them an extra frame to do it, but hey, they're not going to fight as they lock up a nice road victory here in 10 innings.
And tonight's one-run game comes to an end 6-5, the final. The Scranton-Wilkes-Barre Railriders put up a four spot in the opening frame on the way to victory. Tyler Cunningham earns his third win of the year in relief. So that just about does it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way on over to theshownation.com.